If you're interested in tuning European cars, traditionally there hasn't been a lot of support with aftermarket commercial reflashing software, and the go-to option for years has been WinOLS. Now, the problem with WinOLS is that it requires quite a lot of knowledge in order to use it, and this has also meant that the tuners who are really good with it and have figured out how to utilize it don't really like sharing their secrets, so it's been a bit of an area that's shrouded in mystery. There's two ways of working with WinOLS. One of them is to find and define your own maps, or alternatively, you can purchase a map pack, which kind of does the heavy lifting for you. Let's jump into OLS and see what this all looks like and what it actually even is. So we're looking here at the raw binary file that's been downloaded, in this case out of a Mark V Volkswagen Golf, and this uses a Bosch MED 9.1 controller, which is admittedly a bit of an older controller, but the process is essentially the same. So OLS is a binary editor. It allows us to visualize, see, and then make modifications to the memory locations in the ECU. And if we get this right, we can change the correct memory locations to adjust our tuning parameters as we see fit. The problem is, as we can see here, this doesn't make a lot of sense. It's a bit like staring into the matrix. Now, if we've got a map pack, we can see over here on the left-hand side, basically someone's gone through and defined essentially all of the maps that we need in order to perform a stage one tune on this particular vehicle. That process of defining basically means providing a roadmap. So it says at what memory address a particular map is, what size it is, where the axes are, and then just as importantly, some scaling information for those axes and map data. So let's have a look at what a defined map looks like. We'll go to this one here, which is driver's relative torque request, essentially what the driver is asking for on the throttle pedal. And in the MED controller, this is a percentage of maximum engine torque. So the numbers go from 0 to 100. Looking at this map, it all makes sense. On our vertical axis here, we've got our driver's accelerator pedal position. And on our horizontal axis, we've got our engine speed. The numbers, of course, in the table are our desired torque, again, relative torque as a percentage. So that's fine. With this map pack, the heavy lifting's been done. We've now got a map that we can see. It makes sense to us as a tuner, and we can make modifications to suit our requirements. But what if we didn't have a map pack? Well, if we close this down and we have a look at this in a two-dimensional format, what we're using with WinOLS is pattern recognition. So when we see a map that looks like this, this is represented in a two-dimensional view, we would recognize this as a driver's wish or driver's torque request map. So it's that shape that's important. When we see that, we know that's what we're looking at. However, that's only part of the process, because once we've found the map, we also need to provide some scaling data. So let's have a look at this one here, which is not scaled. This is what the map would look like when we first open it up. And the numbers, of course, to us don't make any sense. Our accelerator pedal position now scales from 0 out to 65,535. Our engine speed goes all the way out to 24,000, probably a touch optimistic for a four-cylinder turbocharged engine. And our driver's torque request goes out to 32,768. However, once we understand a little bit more about how the controller works and the logical sequence of numbers that we tend to see inside of these controllers, there's going to be a few hints for us. Let's start by double-clicking on our throttle position axis, and that value 65,535. This is actually the largest number that can be represented by a 16-bit value. So when we know that, we can use this to our advantage. So what we're going to do is apply some scaling. We've already given this a name just to speed things along a little bit. We're going to come down here to our little function button, and we're going to click on that. Now what we can do is apply the scaling to our output. And while I do this, you'll actually be able to see the numbers on the left-hand side change. So if I enter a value of 65, we'll see that that jumps down. So now our maximum value is 1008. Obviously still a little bit high, so we're close, but not quite there. We'll add another 5. Now we're scaling between 0 to 100, so it actually already looks like throttle position. We now want to add a decimal place because we want to be complete here. Our number is 65,536. And now we're 0 to 100, exactly like we should be. We can also come back here and we can add a little bit of precision here, so maybe a decimal place if we want, and our job is done there. So that's our throttle position scaled. Our engine RPM, if we double click on our x-axis, this is a little bit different. The factor that Bosch use in the MED controller is a factor of 0.25, so multiply by 0.25 or divide by 4. How are you going to come across this? Well, that is a little bit tricky. I am showing a pretty simple controller here, and sometimes you will require what is referred to as a description file, which is basically Bosch's internal document that explains the complete logic flow of the ECU and all of the factors and scaling associated. These can be a little bit tricky to get hold of for more modern ECUs. So whether you can get one of these is going to be a little bit up in the air. Obviously, Bosch don't go around handing these out willy-nilly to people. Anyway, we come down here to our value, and again, we can do this one of two ways. We can either multiply by 0.25, and we can see now we're scaling between 400 and 6,000 RPM. Makes sense. Or alternatively, we could come back and make this one, come down to our little function button like we did before, click on our output, and of course, dividing by a factor of 4, that is exactly the same as multiplying by a factor of 0.25. Either way, our job is done. We do still need to scale our map data, so we can click on the map axis over here, which will show us our map or z-axis data. And again, we know that the values here are going to scale between 0 and 100%. This is relative torque, so that's what we're after. And again, we know that this value here in our logical order of numbers is one that will stick out to us. So let's go to our little function button again, and we're going to this time divide our output by a factor of 327.68. So basically just dividing it by itself. Obviously it's important where we put that decimal place, so we are going between 0 and 100. We'll click OK, and again we can add a couple of decimal places there to give us a little bit more precision. That is the process that we go through when we're finding and defining maps. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. It's not always easy. It's definitely not always as easy as the map that I just found there, but that is the process. It starts with pattern recognition, using the two-dimensional display in WinOLS to find the patterns that we're interested in, and then turning these into maps, and then applying scaling in order to turn those raw values into something that we as tuners can understand and then use in order to make tuning changes to the vehicle.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.